and his clients live in the Otago region, he said. Apparently they hold business travel documentation to cross alert level boundaries. Now that came from MBIE, but it's specific, and now they're having a look. The police are having a look at whether that specificity, in fact, stacks up. So it was a Mustang, a Cessna Mustang, and it landed in Wanaka, leaving Auckland at 9:46 a.m. Landed a couple of hours later. But I think what this really highlights, guys, is that these guys, people were dogged in. I think it's pretty hard if you're flying into Wanaka with a jet, not to be noticed, and they were dogged in. And so too, of course, were the couple that have now come out and profusely apologised. And I think what it highlights is that this bubble is being burst on a number of occasions. And you only have to look at Auckland now into our fifth week. And as I do, I go out for a long walk every day. The traffic on the roads is much heavier than what it was a couple of weeks ago. So people are sort of easing up a bit, I think. And I think the crossing of the border, unless they're dogged in, has been going on probably more than what we realise.
What about the guy? He's a so-called essential worker, and he got pulled over by the police, and he said, I'm an essential worker and I'm transporting my goods. And it was a speedboat, his buddy.
It's an essential.
We're taking it to the patch.
It depends what essential work he's doing there. Okay, hey, Barry, understand that there's a new boys club, alliance formed between the US, the UK and Australia, and we're left on the outside looking in.
Yeah, this one is called AUKUS, and it's certainly AUKUS for New Zealand, that is, because we're part of the Five Eyes, and that includes the United Kingdom, the United States and Australia, along with Canada. Now, this excludes Canada and New Zealand, and but you've got to look at the centrepiece for all of this, for this new defence arrangement, and that is the building of nuclear submarines. And they're going to be, the Americans are obviously going to advise the Australians, and they're going to be built in Canberra. Now, the thing for New Zealand is, of course, we still have a nuclear ban in place. Submarines will never come into our waters. They're being built by Australians who bought into this because the nuclear subs obviously have greater range than the aging diesel electric boats that they operate at present. But you can imagine how the French feel about this deal, because Canberra will be walking away from a 100 billion dollar deal that it had with a French shipbuilder, and that could certainly create some diplomatic row with France. But it's interesting though, the linkage for these three countries, because it'll be signed by Boris Johnson and Scott Morrison next week, when the leaders in the United States form the United Nations General Assembly. We were, me and a colleague were waiting out outside the room, and the Secret Service came up to us and they said, you needn't think you're going to be talking to Secretary Schultz. And we thought otherwise, and when Schultz emerged, we called up to him, and he came over. My friend was garroted and taken out of play by the Secret Service. I was slammed up against the wall, had the fingers under my ribcage, but nevertheless, put a microphone over the top of it and got the comment out of George Schultz that we part as friends. And it's almost immortalised, that phrase. And then it became we part, not that very, very French, remember. That was Colin Powell said to Helen Clark. And then we became very, very, very good friends. And then when we finally up on the reason I said, I know I. So, even though this group might try to exclude us, we're still seen as allies, I think.
Yeah. And if Jacinda Ardern is my kind of GA, they should have put James Short. He'll go anywhere.
Well, he'd go, yes, exactly.
Hey, now, Barry, every economist that I looked at was thinking that GDP growth would be somewhere between sort of 1.1 and 1.5% GDP. The June quarter is magnificent, really, isn't it?
2.8, which is extraordinary. And it gives the annual growth rate for the year over 5%. And I think, you've got to look at this pretty realistically, that it's built on the back of very heavy debt in New Zealand. And that's a point that was made by ACT. It said, David Seymour said that the Treasury Secretary, Coralie Pledge, she's telling a real story. She said before the latest lockdown, New Zealand had already had the second largest fiscal stimulus in the world. And that's, backing up business during the COVID crisis. So this is built, like I said, on the back of very, very heavy debt. And it's something of a false economy at the moment, even though we've got to say that the business community reacted pretty well, and so too did Kiwis in terms of their spending. And that drives the GDP, of course. Is it sustainable? Well, that is the question. We're back in lockdown again, as you well know, particularly in Auckland.
Yeah, absolutely. Barry, thank you very much for the catch-up. Have a good day.
Nice talking to you guys. Cheers.
19 past 12, News Talk's head beat, Chelsea Daniels joins us right after this.
South Bank Trucks. Nobody is more committed to your uptime. Enjoy the best parts and service backup in the industry. From South Bank Trucks. Kiwis on the same road.
Looking to start or add to your investment portfolio? Take advantage of affordable properties in Christchurch. Mike Greer Homes has a range of brand new townhouses in suburban Christchurch just released to the market. Priced from just $659,000, these two and three bedroom homes won't last long. So call 0800 Mike Greer or visit mikegreerhomes.co.nz.
Come home to more with Mike Greer Homes.
Mike has binge-watched every program his brain can absorb. Emma painted her toenails 7 times. Otis started collecting Maybelline to make a cricket ball. And Melissa ate the entire contents of her freezer, including the dog roll. Yep, lockdown's no fun.